Thank you for the welcome words. Father Jim had been, all these days was very encouraging, very supportive. So I thank Father Jim especially for that. We are 7 children at home, 4 boys and 3 girls. I am the 5th in order. My father passed away in 97. Mother is alive. She is 85. She has sent me here with her blessing. She walks to the church for daily mass. It is about 1/4 mile. She is one of the first ones to enter the church, and she attends the adoration mass, and if there is a second mass, she might even stay for the second mass. And I am now 52. I was ordained 1994, so I completed 20 years of my priesthood. You are all familiar with an India of lions, tigers, elephants, snakes, lot of poverty and misery. That is mostly depicted in the media. Allow me to state few facts about India. India is a land of mystics and magicians, sages and scientists, poets and philosophers, millionaires and paupers, floods and drought. In short, it is a land of many paradoxes. In India, there is only one season, hot, hotter and hottest. And it is only 80 degrees, and it goes up to 120 to 130 degrees in India, where I am coming from. In area, India is 1/3 of the US, and it has a population almost 4 times that of the US. At present we are more than 1.25 billion. In the US, you can travel its length and breadth speaking one language, English. In India, there are 22 official languages with its own script, grammar and literature. There are also nearly more than 200 tribal languages with its own dialects. When you move around the US, you meet people who are either Christians, atheists. But in India, we have people who belong to 7 major religions of the world, of which 4 of them originated in India. There are also other tribal religious groups. US history dates back to 1492, the year Columbus came to America. India's Vedic period dates back to 6500 BC to 1000 BC. Some of us in India are called St. Thomas Christians. And the tradition goes that the apostle St. Thomas came to India and converted a group of us, and that is why we are called St. Thomas Christians. That is in the first century. US Declaration of Independence of July 4th, 1776, 238 years old. While India attained independence only 67 years ago, for a general election in India, 700 million go to vote to form a government. It is more than twice the total population of the US. India is culturally rich but economically poor. The disparity between the rich and the poor is very big. 40% of Indians not even have a dollar a day for their maintenance. And it is the 10% of Indians who are very rich, who owns practically more than 90% of the wealth of India. There is also caste inequality. There are some who belong to the higher caste and the lower caste and the outcasts. We Catholics in India are only 1% of the population. As Father mentioned, I belonged to the religious order of the Salesians of Don Bosco. Mostly we worked with the deprived children. Last 11 years I was in an institute called Navajivan Balabhavan. Navajivan translated, it is a new life for children. And we had an average, last 11 years we had an average of 1,200 children under our care. That is almost 600, almost half of them under residential care, and the others from the slums comes for tuitions and other service, others support. And they leave home. They are, it is a special program for the street and working children. These children leave home because of different reasons. Leave home, their parents, they are onto the street, mostly onto the railway station. The city where I worked, it is a large railway station, and we used to have 10 to 15 children daily, new ones, arriving in the station, looking for shelter, looking for food. We used to educate the younger ones. We used to have vocational training for the little grown-up ones. The reintegration into the family was our main priority, in putting them back into the families. I am here not because I did not like the work, but because I felt that the work that I was doing could be done by any social worker. Among the children, there were no Catholics, so I had no community for the celebration of the Eucharist. There was no need to administer sacraments for which I was ordained. That is the reason why I left India, just to have a different experience. So kindly keep me in your prayers. Thanks for the warm welcome that you have given to me. Thank you.